Hello everyone, my name is Billy Vandergaal, and that is also my gamertag, and I'm going to show you how to game the Halo Waypoint custom challenges that you can set for yourself and your friends to make about 13,000 credits in 15 minutes. And it's very simple, and I'll show you how this works. So what you do is you sign in to Halo Waypoint, and you click on this little arrow, and you go to Challenges, and you do View Challenges. And what it's going to do is it's going to bring up your challenge page. And I've set some challenges in here because this is ongoing in my living room right now on my Xbox. But I'll show you what I set up and how. So what you can do is you can set up specific challenges that give you credits. It's kind of how 343 envisioned, you know, well, we make our own challenges, you know, and you want to make your own challenges. Sometimes the challenges are just boring. And this is what they created. And if you look here, what you'll see is I've got a challenge here that's running. Challenges run a minimum of 3 hours to 60 hours. The best thing to do is to set it to 3 hours because you're going to complete these challenges in 15 minutes or less. And what I have here is I have the credits. The only one you can max out in 15 minutes is definitely going to be medals. If you all the challenges can only be maxed out to 5,000 credits, and what you need to do is find the sweet spots for them. And your numbers will differ, but these are my numbers right now with the game I'm running. Each time I play, I get about 1,700 medals, but you only need 1,200 to get 5,000 to cap it out. So that's why this challenge is 1,200 medals. Down here, we have 400 enemies. That is a jackal infantry that I have. In 15 minutes, I can kill 400 jackal infantry and more, actually. And I just set it 400 because I know it's a safe minimum that I'm always going to get each game. And that gives me 1,758 credits. The next one up is 300, which is jackal skirmishers. I kill about 300 in, you know, 15 minutes. That gives me 2,637. Now, the reason it gives me more is because jackal skirmishers are hard to kill. That's why there's more points for less enemies. And then down here, you know, you see this 190 is actually elite infantry, and there's 1,670 credits for that. And then right here, you'll see that it's kills with a weapon. And this kills for a weapon is only at 1023 because the reach system freaks out and can't count higher than 1,023 kills per game. So that's your cap, no matter what you do. If you do 1,024, you would have to play two games to break that limiter. But the nice thing is adding all these up together, when I complete these per game, I get 13,313 points. You can see here that I've completed a few of them, and there's one here forfeited because I didn't put the numbers in right. But that's how it works. It's very simple. What I'm using for the weapon is a laser designator, and I'm doing the Oni trick, which I'll show you here right now. So when you're going to play this, it's pretty simple. It doesn't matter what difficulty you have it on. I just set it on normal because it makes it so much easier. I turn on three skulls every time I play, but the most important one to have is cowbell because you want a huge explosion. And then grunt happy birthday, and I would have been your daddy. It's just for fun. Just for helping you get the grenade that you need, might as well just turn on catch. The reason being is you need a plasma grenade to do this trick. I usually just run through, but if you're having a hard time, if you turn that on, it guarantees you a plasma grenade drop from an enemy that you can pick up and use. So I turn on scoring so you can see scoring and everything, and you just load up Bony Sword Base and just start. You can skip the cutscene. All right. And you just run right on up here, and you take out this elite. Now you got your plasma grenade. You want to switch that, and just continue on down here to do the laser designator trick. Drop down. Walk over here. Look at the ground. Hit your checkpoint. And you'll get the kills. Now the reason you want to look at the ground and hit your checkpoint, so you can throw the plasma grenade and stick yourself and kill yourself. What this does is it'll revert you back to the checkpoint. Your laser designator lands, you get kills. Now, if you kill yourself too many times, what happens is it will revert you to the previous checkpoint. So to prevent that, we go save quit, we go yes. And what this does is it makes this checkpoint a permanent checkpoint when you hit resume. Now, what you want to do is you want to take your controller, whatever button you have as your grenade in your control setup, and tape that button down. For me, I use boxer, so right bumper is my grenade. And what I'll do is I'll just hit resume, tape down the grenade button, and what will happen is I will throw a grenade, kill myself, the bombs will drop in from the airstrike, and that will kill everything. It'll give me killionaires, it'll give me all kinds of kills, plus it will give me after the grave medals. And see, boom, 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 just ranking up. And you just let this roll. I found that if you let this go for about 12 to 15 minutes, that gets you all the kills and all the medals. And it will get you about 15, maybe all 18,000 or 1,800, sorry, kills with the laser designator. And the particular enemies depends how many jackals were actually there when that came down. So it might take a couple games where they go through, or you can let it run for 20 minutes. The nice thing about this is you get about 10,000 to 15,000 in a 20-minute period, which is much faster than actually getting it by playing multiplayer. So that's the trick. Now, this game just completed, so I'm just going to hit F5, and this will refresh. And if you turn on the Skull Thunderstorm, which gives major upgrades, the higher rank an enemy is, the more points you'll get out of them for credits. And so that helps out a lot. So if you don't do it on normal, if you do it on heroic or even, dear God, legendary, you can make bank on this real fast. But this is just showing you the simple, easy way of doing it on normal. But you see here that I've got 1,714 out of 1,200. I got 442 out of 400. I got 329 out of 300. I got 196 out of 190. And I got 1,023. So I can go through and I can collect on these. Yep. Whoops. Try that again. Click on it once. There we go. I want to turn it in. Get 5,000. Now what it'll say is it'll say, are you sure to turn this challenge? Your credits will only be awarded once the challenge has expired. The challenge won't expire for another 2 hours and 44 minutes. So 2 hours and 44 minutes after I collect on all these, I will get 13,000 applied to my account. That's the genius on this, is you can do this for an hour a day, and you can make 50,000. You can do this for 3 hours, and you can just make bank left and right on the whole process. If you want to read a book or you want to watch TV shows in between collecting, you know, you can. I mean, I've been playing with this for the last 3 hours, and I've made about 200,000 in 3 hours. That's a ridiculous amount. I mean, you're basically making per game about as much as the weekly challenges. So, you know, that's what you can do. And you can keep recreating it and keep banking on it constantly. It's a pretty sweet deal. Anyways, that's it. And here's an example of just tweaking this. I turned it up to heroic and I turned on the thunderstorm. So now, as you see here, I can make 19,230 credits every 15 minutes just by killing 600 Jackal Specialists, 300 Skirmisher Specs, 200 Grunt Heroes, and 200 Elite Specialists, and doing the medals. I didn't even put in the Laser Designator because the Laser Designator is 300 credits below the lowest ones here, which are the 200 Elite Specialists and Grunt Heroes. So it's not even really worth it for the 300 to have these other ones. And so when you add all this together, you know, I'm getting 19 grand in credits every 15 minutes. And that's how you can tweak it. You can even do more if you worked on Legendary, because each character has certain points tied to them based upon their level of skill.